Hello, heart friends and fellow Essenes. Our topic today is on the endocrine system, particularly the adrenals and what they do, how they function, and what harms them, why we might need them. First slide. If you take a look at the fullness of our figure eight flow here of the whole adrenal system, everything works in unison and is tied together. Yet if you look in the very trunk of our body, in that core, we have two pyramid-shaped adrenals that sit atop the kidneys. In that figure eight flow, that element of fire, we are on fire in that trunk part of our body. It is our chi, our ki, our furnace that burns within. We need that energy of our adrenal fire glands. If you start at the top and you come down, we have that alpha thrust that goes through that figure eight flow and into that first adrenal gland. And then as it comes down and we live our lives through raising our children, we go down into our reproductive organ part of the endocrine system. And if we make sure and keep enough fire and don't dissipate too much, getting stuck in the world of form, then we utilize the energy of that fire to have our omega return going through that other kidney and adrenal gland. And if you look, all the endocrine system lines up north and south in that figure eight flow, yet the adrenals are east and west. They also have pattern within pattern, quantum physics, the figure eight flow of the twin pillars, the two candlesticks that stand side by side. They are our 3 o'clock line. And for those of you who know that cosmic clock, the 3 o'clock and the 9 o'clock line, and that 3 o'clock line, God control, is Aries, our fire. And then we have that 9 o'clock line, which is our God reality, Libra, balancing those fires. And it is the organ of the kidneys and adrenals. Now, you cannot separate the two. The kidneys are known primarily as a water element, and then the adrenals are our fire. When you put water and fire perfectly balanced together, what do you have? Steam. Think Old Faithful going off. We need that for that omega return. And if you take and you were to out picture Boyd's pyramids on those two adrenals, and you look at the way they point up to that thymus gland, that also forms a pyramid from east to west, from each adrenal gland up to the thymus, where we walk the talk of going back over the bridge to our upper part of our being. That being said, sunlight activated chemical hormone, electrical beings, we have sunlight feeds the adrenals. For example, we are now moving out of winter and into the sunny days of spring and summer, some of you faster than others. And one of the things that we may think is, oh, the light's too bright for my eyes. I need my sunglasses. Well, guess what? Dr. Jerry Tennant, as an ophthalmologist, eye surgeon, and MD, lets us know that that is a symptom that we are showing of weak adrenals. Have you ever seen the angels come back from the great central sun with sunglasses on because the light was too bright? No. Do we need our sunlight? Sunlight and sun gazing are one of the ways that you can strengthen your adrenals, so remove from your world that which no longer serves you and give yourself that opportunity, increment by increment, to sun gaze, get more sunlight, strengthen your adrenals. That's one way that we do that. The other thing we can know is that the eyes are the farthest extension, outer extension of our brains, and are directly connected to the lens of the eye, our brains, and our nervous system. So think, what are the foods that feed our brain and our nervous system? Also feeds the adrenals. B vitamins. Stress in our world. We need those B vitamins. Whole food form, particularly magnesium. Homeopathic would be MagFos. And magnesium in the mineral world is our Exhale with the purpose. Breathwork always works also. And you can take the gemstones, put them in water, put them out in the sun, make sun tea, and drink your gemstone tea, and it will also help to work with all of that. We then also have the two parts, the facts on the adrenals. We have two parts to that adrenal. We have the outer cortex and the inner part. The outer cortex puts fires out in our body. That would be inflammation. Inflammation is known as the precursor to all disease, and we utilize cortisol in the outer cortex of the adrenals. Our body will put out that chemical hormone to put out inflammation, which is a precursor to all disease, which leads to finally death in the physical body. We need to utilize, take in less that causes us inflammation, so that instead of the adrenals, burned out adrenals, using the cortisol always taking us out of stress mode, fight or flight, then we go to the inner part of the adrenal, which is our adrenaline. Our adrenaline is our jumpstart fire in the morning, and it contains our energy throughout our day, keeping us well-balanced and having the energy to fulfill our divine plan and its purpose. We want that fire, so we just discussed two of the reasons why we may have a weak, burned out, we hear that all the time, burned out adrenals. And that would be our stress. We're going to have stress. Yes. And when we just discussed a few of the things, so breath work, sun gazing, pacing ourselves, the middle way between those two candlesticks of our fire element. We are on fire. Go to the first slide. We're going to discuss the body maps now as to where you find the adrenals, T9, and kidneys, T10. See where it's yellow highlighted in the box? That is the area on our spine that relates to those two areas of our body, and we need to also have our spine in alignment. Next slide. We have, this is Voltaire, the biomeridian points. And if you look yellow highlighted, you will see 8 is the hormones, and that is on the hands. So you can go in and you can work those points on that index finger, or on that finger, thank you, the water element of the kidney, and those hormones, and there's 4 points, and it's yellowed out on there. And then you also see the adrenals. We have 2 of them, so it's on one each foot, and that there on the adrenals, you can see yellowed out is, you can go and work that point. Those are the biomeridian Voltaire points. Next slide. Here in the overview of the teeth, we have all these body maps. And here on the teeth, it is yellowed out. It is your four teeth at the top and at the bottom have to do with your kidney, bladder, and adrenal. So if you have root canals or rotting teeth, if you've harmed those teeth in any way and the energy's not flowing through them, you can figure out through dental work which ones have to do with that meridian. Next slide. Here's another one that's showing the teeth, and again, it correlates. So this one is a newer version, and I just wanted to show from years gone by to now, it is always the same, the body map and the teeth for the adrenals and kidneys and bladder. Next slide. Here we have the body map on the tongue, and if you look at yourself in the mirror at your tongue, you can see the right kidney and left kidney. The tongue should be evenly pinkish, and if there's white, gray, clouded areas, bright red, burning areas, you can know by looking at that kidney area at the back of your tongue as to how your adrenals are doing. Next slide. Body map from our dear Ann Wigmore. Right under the eyes, we have the kidneys. It's yellowed out for you, and the adrenals. So we can tell from white areas under the eyes, blackened moons under the eyes, puffy, baggy eyes, that all is telling us that area is challenged and needs work. Next slide. Moving forward into the future, we have Roger Bazanis and his slide with also the kidney area under and around the eyes. But if you look, he also has yellowed out right there at the corner of each eye, a little red area. And that red area is specifically where we know that the adrenals are located. That area also of the eye, if you have a lot of wrinkles or crow's feet, you can know that you need to work with the homeopathic MagFoss is for that area. And if you do emotional freedom technique with tapping, you can tap that corner area of the eye, and that is known for the emotional freedom technique because that's where that meridian ends, right there at the adrenals. Next slide. Body map on the ear, known as auricular therapy. You can look where it's highlighted out. The yellow dots show us where those points are, and you can hold on those points or have acupuncture done on those points for the body map of the ears and find those areas. And you can test that yourself. You can get up with your little fingernail and press on that area and see, oh, how are my adrenals doing? Yeah, I can't really see it here on the film, but it is right where it was shown. Yeah, can't tell with my hand in the way. Thank you very much. Next slide. Here we have things that may challenge your adrenals. Caffeine in coffee or any of the caffeinated drinks is harmless. Harmless? Is caffeine health food? Nope. And it crashes our kidneys. It literally puts them in a cast to where we are not utilizing them well. And next slide, you can see the effects of caffeine. It truly is a drug, or methamphetamine use on the mind and body. It is the exact same. And if you will look down in the yellowed out corner, it damages our kidneys, and they are tied directly with our adrenals. It puts our fire out in our chi, in that trunk of our body. Also, cold drinks. Will icy cold drinks, they say, to drink your fluids more room temperature, because the icy cold will be putting out your chi, your ki, your furnace, if you're doing it continually. So you can look on that list and see what it affects and find, oh, I may have a few of those besides needing to reach for my sunglasses when I go out in the sun. Go ahead, next slide. The amount of caffeine needed per week to cause cancer is very, very little. 1 2-ounce energy drink, 1 6-ounce cup of decaf, or 1 6-ounce cup of regular coffee. In the alternative world, cancer is being called a slow-burning electrical fire. Your fire element is your adrenals. Go ahead, next slide. Following through, before we get into some, the last but not least, this is tangerine quartz. It's so beautiful. I'll let you meditate on that while I finish. Factually, the World Health Organization says coffee is the world's leading mind-altering drug. So coffee is a drug? Yes. And the World Coffee Consortium knows what it sells and wants every human to be drinking it. Caffeine is a drug. Pure caffeine powder has been banned and was a long time ago because as little as 1 teaspoonful can kill in as little as 7 minutes because it can burst the heart in just moments. But the FDA doesn't think it should ban coffee. John Pemberton started Coca-Cola in 1896. A veteran of the Civil War, he knew what cocaine was and could do. So it became an essential part of his cola until the Pure Food and Drug Act of 1906 changed that. Taking cocaine out, he replaced it with its equally toxic but legal cousin, caffeine. So now let's go to the healing elements of our gemstones. We have a list of gemstones that work well for the adrenals, and that list is adamite, amazonite, chrysocolla, ocean jasper, tangerine quartz, tanzanite, topaz, golden zircon. With our adamite, just a few things. I know we don't have a picture of it, but it's fun to read. In your book of stones that we now carry here at the bookstore, it lists those gemstones for your adrenals and how to strengthen them with our gemstones. It gives us a lot of insight. Adamite is a stone for enhancing the alignment of the heart and solar plexus chakras, thus allowing one to synergize one's will with one's feelings. We know that the endocrine hormone system is strongly related to our emotions and feelings. Such an alignment is particularly helpful for achieving one's heart's desires, the aspects of life one longs for, but which may seem impossible to realize. Strong adrenals give us the energy to fulfill our divine purpose on that omega return back to the heart of God. It carries the energy of joyful inner child and the wise higher self, reminding us both of our innate innocence and our unbreakable connection of our divine source. Adamite is useful in stimulating and supporting the adrenal glands. We then also have a little bit of information on our gemstone, amazonite. Amazonite in your Book of Stones, page 22. The 7th chapter of the Egyptian Book of the Dead was engraved in amazonite, and it's believed to have been the 3rd stone in the breastplate of Moses. It frees one to identify and set strong and clear boundaries on physical, energetic, and emotional levels. A lot of us need that. There can be internal boundaries that help one to develop self-discipline or external boundaries that assist one in defining one's personal space, walking one's talk, aligning one's actions with one's words. I want to make sure we have time to get to our orange tangerine. It's so beautiful. I think we have time for one more. Chrysocolla is a stone of empowerment of the feminine energies in both men and women. It emanates gentleness and power, teaching that genuine power best expresses itself through gentleness. That would be the actionless action, the way of the Tao. Ocean jasper is so beautiful. There's so many things we could read about that. That's on page 286. But we're going to go right to tangerine quartz. It is a fire element. May we put that picture of our tangerine quartz back up? It is so beautiful. And you can hold these gemstones as well as making your gemstone tea and get the energy from them. If you have strong adrenals, you can, by standing next to the person who may have a flickering flame going out, you can stand next to them and it will emanate from your being and help their adrenals to strengthen and give them energy, reignite their flame. Tangerine quartz can be used to help overcome seemingly insurmountable limitations or problems. It gives one hope, resolves one's will, creative problem solving. It is for overcoming fear of that which we may feel like we're not good enough. It helps one bypass the ego and honestly assesses one's skills, seeing what one still needs to learn. Tangerine quartz stimulates the glands, helps stimulate sluggish adrenals, and it's a good stone to employ for countering all other fire element energies. So, in review, strengthen your adrenals. They are our fire element. They are our omega return. We need that to fulfill our divine purpose in life. Our twin flame, the 3x3, is our twin pillars, our candlesticks. I believe there is a figure eight flow pattern among patterns between both of our adrenals. And again, think of Boyd's pyramids pointing up, making that full pyramid from our adrenals up back up to the thymus, walking the walk. Back to you, Boyd.
Thanks, Marlena. Good job.